In today's video, we're gonna learn how to make a fillable form in Adobe Acrobat Pro DC. Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. My name is Sean Jordison, and let's jump right in. The fastest method to make this a fillable PDF form is to select the Prepare a Form option from the All Tools menu on the left-hand side. And from here, we are going to choose this document. You could scan a document, you could start from a blank page or create a web form, but we're just gonna create from this document and select Create Form. And voila, it puts the form fields inside of our document. Now I can back out of the form area. And there's a couple of things we can do to our form fields. Like if we wanted to provide some conditional formatting, as an example, I could go back into my Prepare a Form option. We can right click it and then select Properties. And this will bring up the text field properties for this specific form field. This is where we can also update tooltips, our appearance, things like font size auto or the different types of font. You could even change the text color. You could change the position of the form field. We can put in a default value, like I could just put in first name as an example. We could make it multi-line if we wanted to. This would allow the user to add extra content where they needed to. We could add actions on here. We can format it to like maybe be a date or a time. We could also validate it if we want it to be something specific, and we could even set calculations. Now with that said, our form fields are in here appropriately, but what we need to do now is actually like tag them. Obviously, I am the accessibility guy, so I'm going to make this document accessible. Why don't we go ahead and just check out where we are? Let's go ahead and run the accessibility checker and see what kind of trouble we have. Tagged annotations. Okay, that's fine. That's the signature field. Tagged form fields. They are not currently tagged. Perfect. Well, let's see what we can do. So there's an option here called automatically tag form fields, but it's kind of like disabled. So here's what we're gonna do. I'm going to create a new tag in my tags panel with a blank P tag. I'm then going to select the accessibility options button and select find, and I wanna find all of my unmarked annotations. Sometimes the form fields, they are considered annotations, and we are going to search the page for them, and it already begins to find them. So I'm gonna select tag element, tag element, tag, 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 tag. Like that. And now all of these nice form fields are in the right, they're now at least in my document. So now I actually have to go place them. So I'm gonna take my first name object reference and cut it, and we're gonna move it to our first name location, like that. We can then go take our email address and make sure we put it in our email address section. Let's take last name, and we'll put it in our last name section. Signature should be in this P tag. And then we have some checkbox items. Do you know who Sean Jordison is? Probably not. Phone number, which is pretty cool. We can put it in the phone number field. And all I'm doing right now is just putting like these objects where they belong. Do you have experience with accessibility? Probably not. All right, let's go ahead and I'm gonna expand my tags out. So there's a couple of things we need to do. We are gonna get additional errors if we don't put all of these nice object references into form parent tags. So these parentless child tags need parents. Let's give them to them. I'm gonna right click this first name container, select new tag, and type in the word form. And we're gonna do the same thing again. I'm gonna select last name, right click, new tag, form. And as you do this more and more, you will get faster and faster, and you may find yourself doing it in a different order than I am. Normally, I finish off like an entire form section before moving on to the next one, but you know, here we are. And now that we have our parent form tag, we need to drag our child tag inside of it. This is an important step, and this is going to help us maintain the accessibility throughout our journey here. So I'm just dragging all of these child tags into their form parent tags. Now let's go ahead and run the accessibility checker. And look at that. We have like a mostly accessible document. Now I like to go above and beyond. So we're gonna address, we're gonna check out these tooltips. So I just wanna make sure they're right. I'm gonna select my prepare form button, and then I can see the tooltips. So we got first name, phone number, last name. I'm gonna drag that up and then move email address, your phone number. Do you have experience with accessibility? Are you new? Do you know Sean? Signature. All right, this is perfect. If I wanted to update the tooltip, I could select properties and we can add extra things in here if we wanted to, like, hey, who is Sean? That's not really a relevant tooltip. You could do something like instead on the first name, you could say like, please enter your first name. Now it's a little redundant. However, the point I'm trying to make here is that you need to check it. You need to check the tooltips to make sure they are valid. This is a very simple document, but if I had like 1,000 more form fields, it might become problematic if I do not check my tooltips. Additionally, like if we had the first name field somewhere else in the document, you're gonna get an error by having the form fields named the same or having the same tooltips. So it's important that you like spend time reviewing this. We've already moved them to the correct location. You know, but as I'm doing this, I'm actually noticing something. This is like coming through poorly. So there's a little square in here that says, are you new to accessibility? I think that if I launch JAWS right now, it's gonna give me some trouble with how it's going to announce that object. Let's go ahead and just see what happens. I'm going a little off the script here. I normally don't launch assistive technology while I'm recording because it creates problems, but here we are.
JAWS splitting sounds tip for JAWS form sample dash Adobe Acrobat Pro left parent 64.1 form to snap. The accessibility guide.
All right, I'm gonna try to get down to this bullet so we can listen to it.
Heading level one application for the accessibility guide. This app, please and email address edit. First name, colon, last name, colon. Phone number, colon, email address, colon. Ballot box, do you have experience with accessibility? Phone number edit. Do you have, are you new to accessibility? Checkbox, not.
I think my reading order is off.
Do you know who Sean Jordison is? Signature left pick, please and last phone. Do you, are you new to accessibility? Do you know who Sean Jordison is? Checkbox, not checked. The check, press space.
Okay. So I was using two different methods to navigate. At first, I was using the down arrow keys, which was kind of giving me trouble with the navigation. But then I switched to the traditional method for moving to different fields, which was the tab key. So my reading order is in fact okay. I was just using the wrong command using my keyboard. And what I was trying to get to is if that element was being read incorrectly. It's not, so that's good. But if we just pretend that it was, this is the fix for it. I need to turn off JAWS first though.
JAWS updates, taskbar. JAWS home menu, JAWS context menu, options menu.
One of the first things that you teach someone who's new to JAWS is how to shut it up. Anyways, let's just pretend that it was reading this incorrectly. I can right click the object, select properties, and in the actual text field, I can just retype the words, are you new to accessibility? And this is gonna force the screen reader to read the text and not that funky bullet. Anyways, it's a good thing to do. That concludes today's video on how to create a fillable PDF form in Adobe Acrobat Pro DC. If you made it all the way to the end of the video, hit that subscribe button. And as always, I can be your personal accessibility expert. If you want to find out how I can help you get accessible, take a look at the link in the description of this video. Thank you so much for joining me today, and I'll see you next time.